Sunday Burquest, star of the reality game show Survivor, has passed away at the age of 50 after her latest bout with cancer. The former Survivor contestant had previously been diagnosed with breast cancer in 2012. After several surgeries and treatments, Burquest was cancer-free, but about a year ago she received a second cancer diagnosis. Doctors revealed that Burquest had months to live after discovering she had esophageal and ovarian cancers. The team here at Facts First offers our deepest condolences to the friends and family of Sunday Burquest, an undoubtedly strong and brave woman who will be dearly remembered. Sunday Burquest's longtime battle with cancer. Sunday Burquest, the inspirational youth pastor contestant on 2016's Survivor Millennials vs. Gen X, died Sunday, April 18th after a battle with esophageal and ovarian cancer. It was her second cancer battle in a decade. Her daughter, Kennedy Burquest, confirmed she passed via Instagram and posted a touching tribute to her late mother. She said, quote, "To my unbelievably beautiful mama, thank you. Thank you for fighting as hard as you did for as long as you did. Thank you for being a best friend, a role model, a sister, and my mother all in one." The host of Survivor, Jeff Probst, also paid tribute to Sunday on Instagram, saying Burquest had one of the brightest smiles of any person to ever play Survivor. He continued saying she radiated kindness and understanding to anyone lucky enough to be in her presence. Burquest had previously written about her battle with cancer in 2018's Grit Girl, Power to Survive. She also gave motivational speeches about pulling through such a challenging ordeal, where she relied heavily on her Christian faith. Burquest was diagnosed with breast cancer in April of 2012. She underwent 5 surgeries, 8 rounds of chemotherapy, and 28 days of radiation. It was important to Sunday that her children saw her as a warrior rather than a whiner. The battle against cancer was hard, but she wouldn't let it take over her life. She claimed that because of her faith, she was able to kick cancer's butt. It was on June 7, 2020, that Burquest posted a video on Instagram announcing she was fighting esophageal and ovarian cancer. During the video, she wore a t-shirt that said, "I survived esophageal and ovarian cancer." A contestant on Survivor. Burquest made a name for herself on the 33rd season of CBS's reality game show Survivor. The season was nicknamed Survivor Millennials vs. Gen X, where it featured 10 contestants born before 1982 and 10 born after 1984. By the end of Sunday Burquest's run on the show, she ended up in an impressive 7th place as the 14th contestant voted off on day 35. Burquest had garnered the respect of others by eventually making her way into the Millennial tribe despite starting in the older cohort. A mother of 4 who listed her occupation as youth pastor, Burquest was the oldest woman contestant on the show at 45. A former contestant of the show, Zeke Smith, also posted a tribute on Instagram. Referring to her as Darling Sunday, he said he'll love and remember her for all his days. Hey, if you're enjoying this video so far, make sure you give it a like and subscribe to Facts First if you haven't already. And stick around to find out more about Survivor members we've lost. To honor the memory of Sunday Burquest, we'd like to take a look at the other members of the Survivor family who we've lost over the years. Jen Lyon. Jen Lyon finished 4th place on the 10th season, in what was Survivor's first fire-making tiebreaker. She was diagnosed with stage 3 breast cancer in 2005, shortly after her season of the show aired. While battling cancer for 5 years, she was involved in numerous charities and foundations in support of cancer education, research, and awareness. The Survivor Palau 4th place finisher was the first member of the Survivor family to pass away. She died in 2010 at age 37. Angie Jacuz. Cassandra Ann Angie Jacuz passed away at the age of 40 after a 3-year battle with a rare form of squamous cell colorectal cancer. The New Orleans native rose to fame in 2005 when she starred on Survivor Palau, the reality show's 10th season on CBS. Angie was almost voted out in the first episode after struggling in the challenge, but Jolanda Jones received more votes at the tribal council. Jacuz rebounded in the second episode by being solely responsible for winning the fishing gear reward for her Oolong tribe. She's the second Palau castaway to pass away after Jen Lyon. Cliff Robinson. Cliff Robinson was the first ever professional basketball player to appear on the show. The former NBA star and Survivor Cagayan Brains vs. Brawn vs. Beauty alum died at the age of 53 of lymphoma. In 2014, he participated in the 28th season as part of the Brawn tribe, and the towering athlete tried to keep his identity a secret. He was the 5th person voted out of the game. Robinson had previously suffered a brain hemorrhage in March of 2017. He had an 18-year career in the NBA, including most notably for the Portland Trailblazers. He's survived by his mother, sisters, three brothers, and six children. Rudy Besch. Rudy Besch was a Navy veteran who held the distinction of being the oldest person to ever play Survivor. In the show's iconic first season, at age 72, Besch lucked into an alliance early on with fellow tribe members Richard Hatch, Kelly Wigglesworth, and Susan Hawk. The unlikely group became a dominant force as the 39 days progressed. All four made it into the finale. Hatch ended up winning the $1 million prize by one vote over Wigglesworth. Rudy placed third and Hawk came in fourth. Rudy then broke the record as the oldest person to play for the second time when he returned in All-Stars at age 75. He was the second person voted out. The Survivor legend passed away in 2019 at age 91 following complications in his battle with Alzheimer's disease. Ashley Massaro. Ashley Massaro was a castaway on Survivor China, the 15th season of the show. Better known for her professional wrestling career in the WWE, Massaro debuted there as part of the WWE Diva Search in 2005. She passed away in May 2019. The cause of her death was not released by New York Suffolk County Medical Examiner's Office due to privacy laws, but sources told TMZ at the time she had died by suicide. Her death occurred just 10 days before her 40th birthday. According to CNN, following Massaro's death, she wanted her brain donated to chronic traumatic encephalopathy research. CTE is a condition that happens after repeated head injuries, but can't be diagnosed in a living person. It can cause memory loss, mood swings, rage, and suicidal thoughts. She is survived by her daughter, Alexa. Dan Kaye. Dan Kaye competed in the 17th season of Survivor. He came in 11th place on Survivor Gabon. In late 2016, Kaye died at the age of 40. His girlfriend at the time, Jennifer DiPietro, told Radar Online they were not releasing the cause of death. But the Brookline, Massachusetts Police Department said they did not suspect foul play. Kaye was survived by his two children. Caleb Bankston. As the fiancé of Survivor One World contestant Colton Cumby, Caleb Bankston competed in the 2013 season Blood vs. Water, featuring players with ties to one another. Bankston was 26 at the time. Caleb was killed a year later in an accidental derailment while working at the Alabama Warrior Railway. Bankston and Cumby's wedding was to have taken place in October 2014, 4 months after Bankston was killed. BB Anderson. BB Anderson was the second player eliminated from the breakout first season of Survivor. At age 64, Anderson was the second oldest player in Borneo, but also one of the most abrasive. One of the contributing factors to his elimination was saying he wouldn't mind if he was voted out, making him an easy first pick for his tribe. Anderson passed away in 2013 after a battle with brain cancer at age 77. His obituary described him as bigger than life with a heart to match. He was survived by his wife, daughter, and four sons. If you'd like to say your condolences or show your respect to Sunday or any of the other Survivor family we've lost, feel free to leave a message in the comments section below. And before you go, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to Facts First if you haven't already. Click the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest content.